Cuff, and just a slight correction. I mentioned that at 7:15 we'd be speaking with Dr. Dania Baugh, and actually a rebroadcast, but it's actually going to be Dr. Karen Carpenter, a clinical sexologist. We're going to be talking about relationships, a conversation we had some time ago. Now, if you just joined us, welcome. We have with us Christopher Johnny Daly. Chris, of course, is a multi-talented actor and comedian, and Andrew Hewitt. And they've teamed up. Andrew's a technical consultant and freelance writer. They've teamed up on Yad Info podcast, The Lightest Side of Jamaican News. It's been around for just under 3 months and already on the Podomatic rankings of, it has had more than, 60,000 international podcasts. And the biggest jump was by 8,300 places in just its first week. So let me give you a chance to listen to it if you haven't yet heard it.
Welcome to Yad Info, the lighter side of Jamaican news. Today's Thursday, July 22nd, and over the next half an hour, we will be taking you through these topics. Parson christening picnic foss. JLP constituencies get majority of road funds. The PM done with Dudus. Give unto Shaw what is due unto Shaw. Next, backdoor deals. Did the PMP and JLP cut a deal to drop dual citizen court cases? Emergency breaks. The PMP halts state of emergency.
Disclaimer. Andrew Hewitt is responsible for these.
Now, we thought, based on the last election, that when the new party came to power, we wouldn't have to be facing the type of situation where you have works and projects being handed over on a partisan basis.
You mean it wouldn't be business as usual?
It's a group, like it's a club. We thought. No, Andrew, you're alone.
I'm alone.
No, honestly.
I'm alone. Andrew, you're alone.
We never get fooled. Andrew, we listen to them go behind the political pulpit. They want to get intricate or something. You just wait to see what go on. That's what you judge them by.
Let me talk for myself.
Andrew, find you know yourself. No, let me ask you. Find you a thought. From you know yourself, I'm MP around constituency. Yeah. I empty MP's money for that. And I am kind of in charge of
and
money.
In charge of the kind of in charge.
Good. So you know I'm in charge of the money. Yeah. You think fame can first of all, him can't drive enough him constituency and the constituency does not look good. First of all, the people who live in there go say, yo, we are Mr. Henry.
Mr. Lester Henry.
What?
In charge of all the road works and
his
constituency.
And Mr. Shah, please look good to him. Talk about Mr. Shah.
Hold on, no. You're right, Mr. Shah, you know it too.
Oh, because
he control the money.
So the man who controls the ministry and the man who controls the money.
Okay.
Two constituencies are receiving 74% of what they call significant special projects.
Yes,
funds.
Man.
Then nobody think something wrong with that.
Special
63 constituencies and two of them getting 74%
special
of the money.
Special projects. Let me tell you something about them projects then. You have a little come over and say your minister, you are dealing with us over there for work with the arm to you.
Yad Info did an interview with Bert Samuels recently.
Yes.
Right? And one of his points was that in order for us to get anything done, and it may be a bit of an uphill task, but it is possible. If we can find anything in the Constitution that says that this gentleman should be removed or this particular government member, we can bring a court case to actually have them removed.
So will I?
And I'm going to speak further on that a little bit more because we have a nice little topic coming up.
Yeah.
That's an excerpt from Yad Info podcast, The Lighter Side of Jamaican News. It's a new podcast, and as I said already, 60,000 international podcasts and 8,300 places in just its first few weeks. And it's been on just about, 3 months. You heard the voices there in case you missed it, the voice of Christopher Daly and Andrew Hewitt along with host Nicole Brown.
Andrew, why are you putting me in trouble, Benji?
Let me ask you something.
I mean, you already put out a disclaimer.
In three months, you guys had any feedback on it from anybody in the news? Like, for example, any ministers of government?
we hope not.
Friends of Dudus.
Well, no. Thankfully, no. Certainly not.
But, entertainment personnel.
Not perhaps the personalities you may be thinking of, but there are a couple of people I know personally in the news media who have said that, you know, they've enjoyed it. It's much better than, I think people initially are skeptic when they hear about it, and they're very surprised when they do hear it. Somebody called me and she was very surprised. It's very good, it's very good.
So how far do you push the boundaries?
I think, quite frankly, as I said to you earlier before we even started the program, the podcast, because of the way he explained it to me, made me feel like I could really, really go at, you know, just freeing up myself and expressing myself. And you kind of hear it. I'm a different personality altogether when I'm doing the podcast. So I do push the envelope. I hope that when people listen to it, though, they know that I'm pushing it from a comedic standpoint, and that I'm, as a comedian, I'm really taking comedic license to do what I do. So
you don't want them to take you seriously?
I want them to take, for instance, the information seriously. For instance, when Andrew makes the point about 70-odd% of the money is going towards these two parishes, that's something that's a fact that's out there. You can't dispute that. What I don't want you to take seriously is when I go off into characterizing the things and, yo, man, you can't do that. I mean, it's a part of who we are, the Jamaican sentiment, but it doesn't mean that it necessarily happens.
Are there any stories that you won't do, that you won't touch?
There was one very recently, something of a more salacious story that I thought it was irresponsible for the media to even cover, because some names were being bandied about that there was no evidence as to these individuals being involved in the whole saga. And yes, you know, there are going to be stories like